In this chapter, we will discuss about display file. We will see how we can design a screen and we will write a program to do on-screen calculation. So let's get started. Display file is a file which contains the DDS of a screen. That is, the display file contains the design of the screen. We use the utility screenDesignAdd to design the screen. The command to start the screen is strsta. We use the command strsta to start the utility screenDesignAdd. Then we select option 1 to design the screen. On the next screen, we enter the source physical file name and library name. We enter the display file name in member. This is the member where the screen DDS will be saved. Now we will press enter to go to the next screen. On the next screen, we can create multiple screens. For each individual screen, a record will be created. All screen records appear here one by one. Let's create a new record or a screen. To create a new record, we enter 1 in the option. On the next screen, we enter the record name and the type of the record. Here we can have different types of record. For example, we can have simple panel, or we can have window, or we can have a subfile. If you want to design a panel, then we need to mention the record type as record. To design a window, we need to mention the record type as window. Let's start with a simple screen or panel. We mention the screen record name as screen1 and record type as record. A blank screen appears. Let's design the screen now. Here we will design a screen where we can enter 2 numbers and can perform arithmetic calculation. So let's start the design. To design the screen, we need to follow some rules. For example, to write plain text, we write the text inside quotes. Then we press enter. While designing, if you make any mistake and we want to erase any character on the screen, then we should never use backspace or delete key like we do in Windows. If you use backspace or delete key, it will lead to bad alignment of the screen content. We must use a space button to erase any character on the screen. For example, if you want to erase calculator text in the text screen calculator, then first we need to put the code at the beginning of the full text, and then we remove the calculator text using a space button, and then we put the ending code for the text. So this is how we erase some characters on the screen. Let's write the complete text again on the screen. Now we will see how we can use display file keyword to place some important information on the screen. For example, we can use star user, star date, star time keyword to place username, current system date, and system time on the screen. Let's place these keywords on the screen and press enter. This is how the screen looks like. Now let's see how we can align the text at the center of the screen. We use the notation AC in front of the text to align the text at the center of the screen. Let's align the text screen calculator at the center of the screen. To align the text at the center, we write AC, that is align center, in front of the text, and then we press enter. The text is aligned at the center of the screen. To move the content to the left, we use less than sign. Number of less than sign denotes the number of spaces we want the text to travel to the left on the screen. For example, to move screen calculator text to the left by 4 spaces, we put less than sign 4 times. When we press enter, then the text is moved to the left by 4 spaces. Similarly, to move the content to the right, we use greater than sign. Number of greater than sign denotes the number of spaces we want the text to move to the right. We use H in front of the field to highlight the text in white on the screen. We use R in front of the field to reverse image the text on the screen. We use U in front of the field to underline any text. We use D in front of the field to delete the field. Now we will see another method to change the attribute of the text. Let's place the text on the screen again. To change the attribute of the text, we can put a star in front of the text and then we press enter. On the next screen, we set the display attribute as yes and then we press enter. The next screen shows us various display attributes that we can set for the text. We enter Y in front of highlight attribute to highlight the text in white. We press enter and enter again to come back to the design screen. We can see that the text is highlighted with white color. Similarly, to get the reverse image of the text, we put a star in front of the text and then we press enter. We set the display attribute as yes and then we set the reverse image to yes. We press enter 2 times to come back to the design screen. We can see the reverse image effect of the text on the screen. Likewise, we can set other attributes. This is the summary of other attributes that we can apply on the text. Now let's see how we can set the color of the text. To set the color of the text, we put a star in front of the text. Then we set the color attribute as yes. We enter 1 in front of yellow color. We press enter key 2 times to come back to the design screen. As expected, the text color is in reverse image and yellow color. Now we try some other combination. We set the display attribute as highlight and color as red. This is how the final text looks like. Similarly, we set the display attribute as underline and color as pink. Then this is how the final text looks like. We can also use the color attribute without any display attribute. For example, we clear the display attribute and put the color as yellow, and we get the text highlighted in yellow color. Let's set the display attribute back to highlight. Now, after designing the header part, we will design the footer part and the main screen content. Let's enter all the text at the same time on the screen and then we press enter. Now we set the color as blue for all the text. Now we will create input and output field on the screen. On the screen, we can create 3 types of field: input field, output field, and both type field. Let's discuss about input field. In case of input field, the screen takes the keyboard input and provides the value to the program. In case of output field, the screen takes the value from the program and then provides this value to the screen. In case of both type field, that is input and output field, this type of field is a combination of input and output field. That is, the screen takes the keyboard input and provides it to the program. Also, it can take the value from the program and display the value as an output on the screen. Depending on our need, we will design different type of field on the screen. Let's see how we can design input and output field on the screen. To design the fields, we use some notations on the screen. For example, for alphanumeric field, we use the notation plus IN. Plus IN is used to create alphanumeric input field of length n, where I stands for input. Similarly, plus ON is used to create alphanumeric output field of length n. Here, O stands for output. Likewise, plus BN is used to create both type of alphanumeric field, that is alphanumeric input and output field. Here, B stands for both, that is input plus output. For numeric field, we use the notation plus 3N, plus 6N, or plus 9N. Plus 3N is used to create a numeric input field of length N, where plus 3 stands for input. Plus 6N is used to create numeric output field of length N, where plus 6 stands for output. Plus 9N is used to create numeric input and output field of length N, where plus 9 stands for input plus output. Similarly, we can use the notation like plus 3 N, 2 to create a decimal input field of integer part N and decimal part 2. We can use plus 6 N, 2 to create decimal output field of integer part N and decimal part 2. We can use plus 9 N, 2 to create decimal input output field of integer part N and decimal part 2. Let's create the input output field on the screen. On this screen, we will create two input fields where we can input some numbers. We will have another input field where we will input arithmetic operator like plus, minus, multiplication or division. Based on what arithmetic operator we use, we will do arithmetic calculation in the program and then we will show the output on the screen. To show the output on the screen, we will have one output field. Let's create the first input field. We enter the notation plus 3, 2, 0 and then we press enter. It will create the input field of length 2. Similarly, to create second input field, we again enter the same notation, that is plus 3, 2, 0 and then we press enter. Third field is again an input field, but it is an alphanumeric field. We will enter the arithmetic operator here. We enter the notation plus I1 to create this input field and we press enter. The last field is an output field and we enter the notation plus 6, 3, 0 and then we press enter. Now we must give a meaningful name to all the input and output field that we have designed so far on the screen. To give the field a proper name, we put question mark on the left of the screen field. Then we press enter. And then we can enter the field name at the bottom of the screen as shown here. By default, we can see the field name as FLD001. This is a system generated field name. Let's change the field name to num001. Similarly, we put question mark in front of second screen field and then we change the field name as num002. Likewise, we change the field names for rest of the fields as OPR001 and num003. Now we press F3 and then we enter option 1 to save all the screen work. We come to the main screen which shows the screen record that we just created.